Alrighty, yeah, I'm back. As you're watching this, you can probably tell, because you're streaming this via YouTube, and it's underneath both of their kids' names, so you're probably thinking, oh yeah, he's back. So yeah, I am back. Yeah, that was like 2 month break from Madden for me. I was just getting bored of it, but now getting back into it, because Madden 12's coming out soon. The lockout just ended. Looking forward to watching football next year. It's gonna be a great time. We're gonna post tons of freaking videos, all that good stuff, and I hope you guys enjoy it all. So, in this game, I'm the Saints, per usual, because they're my team. This guy's the Giants. I know there was a. There's like no score in the first half. Nobody scored in the first quarter, I mean. Kind of one of those slow start games. However, I can like I'm pretty sure I can guarantee you somebody's gonna score with like any second now. I think somebody's gonna have to score. I mean, in second quarter, any second now. But yeah, this guy is a subscriber, viewer, commenter, friend on YouTube, friend on PSN-er, all five of those. So yeah, I've known him for like a year at least, and we've had some good games. This is definitely one of our better ones. First of all, this play is crazy. He picks it up, runs like 50 yards down the field. Drew Brees freaking manhandles him and yanks the ball out like it's his 2-year-old son, and then freaking pile on the ball. And of course I get it, because I'm like the luckiest Madden player in the world, and I've been told that numerous times by different people. I mean, I think I'm pretty lucky, but I don't know about luckiest in the world, but you know, who knows. Yeah, it just took us a while to get our offense going, but as soon as we did, we're lighting up the scoreboard, and you're gonna see that at the end of the game. And yeah, so this is one of those games when you're like one play away from turning off the console and just like eating a big freaking $5 box of Taco Bell and just being depressed because you lost the game and you had no hope at ever winning it. And just like pounding down a half gallon ice cream after that $5 box from Taco Bell. This is one of those games. Because, you know, it only takes one play to make or break a game, and you'll see that like at least a couple times in the fourth quarter. But yeah, that was Mario Manningham on the kick return. Pretty snazzy, pretty good, nice. I think you'll be seeing another one later in the gameplay. He definitely got some kick return skills, I'll give him that. But yeah, right now it's basically just trying to add on a field goal. But there is 15 seconds left, and I kind of underestimated Eli Manning and the New York G-men and their ability to drive down the field in 15 seconds. But yeah, they can do that. So he takes the lead at halftime and feeling a little bit down after he just put a freaking hole in my heart with that touchdown right before the half. But you know, I think hearts heal eventually. But yeah, Mario Manningham didn't have the same luck on punt returns. He muffed it there and wasn't able to take it back. And there's a holding penalty. The whole world was against Mario Manningham after he kick returned on me. God damn you, Manningham. But yep. We're just moving along. Third quarter already. Brandon Jacobs plowing over like snowplow, I guess. It's the only thing I can think of at 2:53 a.m. in the morning to say in this gameplay. Let's see. What happens here? Jabari Greer makes a tackle on Brandon Jacobs. And then he just scores, as you see. He scores, man. He's got the 11-point lead. I'm trailing, praying to the only God I know that a miracle will happen. And, oh, look at that, Henderson, yeah. That was a pretty good start. And then we get 3rd and 10 here, and I'm feeling like Michael Vick on steroids, and, nope, not quite. So now 4th and 27. Yeah, game's over. About to go have myself a Taco Bell meal. Oh! It's not going to be one of those days, perhaps. I'm actually going to enjoy my day after possibly winning this game. So, yeah, only down by 4 now. And the G-Men are looking to add the lead. Vilma does a 360 midair pick. Yeah, pick 6. And we are in the lead now. The Saints just got the lead. And then again, that hole in my heart healed up. But then Manningham puts another one in there. And that was, definitely broke my heart twice this game. And this was the second time. And then he was adding injury to insult, marching like a saint right there to the end zone. But that's all right. We had Drew Brees in the 4th and 14. I somehow just get over the fucking line. This dude was not happy with that play or this whole next drive. In that fact, seeing how most of these first downs are on 4th down plays or 3rd and longs, like that one, and this one, and the rest of the freaking drive. But yeah, 1:02. I'm down by 4, can't kick a field goal, need the touchdown, Reggie Bush, game over. Oh no, he breaks out, keeps the game alive. And then, again, I'm feeling like Michael Vick, and no one's on me, so Drew Brees is just going to take off with that. And again, I'm still feeling Michael Vick in me, so I take off. And I lose the ball, but out of bounds, thank God. 7 seconds left. Throw a dart to Jimmy Graham, and he catches it. And the Saints have a lead, and I win the game. Thank you, God. But then he pulls out this miracle fucking play, and I'm so fucking pissed. But he actually didn't get it, so I'm kind of happy now. It was a great game. I enjoyed it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll be posting some more videos whenever I do. And y'all have a good time. Peace.